Hello everyone, I'm Ms. Susan from the Cape May County Library Children's Department, and this is the art and science of butterflies. Caterpillars and butterflies are out and about. So in this video, we're going to take a look at some caterpillar crafts and some butterfly crafts. The oval tissue paper caterpillar is inspired by author Eric Carle and the Very Hungry Caterpillar book. This adorable caterpillar is easy to make. You'll need red tissue paper, green tissue paper, you can use a couple different shades of green, white or a light colored construction paper, glue, water, paintbrush, pencil, scissors, and a black marker or crayon. I used other marker colors as well when I was decorating the caterpillar at the very end. First, trace the oval shape on the red and green tissue paper. Then cut out your red and green ovals. Once you have lots of green ovals cut out, you're ready to begin. Mix Elmer's glue with water in a bowl. This watered-down glue works well when gluing tissue paper onto construction paper. And now you're ready to build your caterpillar. You can start with the caterpillar's head and build the rest of his body behind it, or you can start with the caterpillar's tail and build all the way up to the head. Imagine what a caterpillar looks like as it crawls along a leaf. That will help you when you build your caterpillar body. Once your caterpillar is totally dry, grab some markers or crayons and add a face, antennae, and legs to your caterpillar. Here I reference Eric Carle's book, The Very Hungry Caterpillar, to design my little caterpillar feet and his face and his antennae. You might even want to add some hairs on top of the caterpillar because some are very hairy. Another easy and super cute caterpillar is the 3D folded paper caterpillar. You'll need green construction paper, circle shape to trace, two googly eyes, scissors, pencil, glue or glue dots, and a black marker or crayon. First, trace and cut out the circles you'll need for your caterpillar's head and body. Here I use different shades of green construction paper too. Once you have a bunch of green circles cut out, then fold the green circles in half. Then I put Elmer's glue on the bottom half of each circle and stacked them one at a time, bending as I went to make the caterpillar's body. Every so often I added a different shade of green circle so that the caterpillar would be more interesting to look at. Once you're happy with the length of the caterpillar, now it's time to make his face. Here I cut out an orange circle and added two antennae and two googly eyes and then a cute mouth. Finally, I glued his head onto the first part of his body. Now let's make some butterflies. The folded paper butterfly explores symmetry with paint. You'll need cover or cardstock, scissors, Crayola paint in bright colors, and some chenille sticks or bendable straws. Begin by folding a plain piece of paper in half. Next, take a pair of scissors and snip off the corners of the folded paper. I cut in and out a little bit on the right side, opposite the fold, to make it look like a bee shape. So when it's unfolded, it has a butterfly shape. While the paper is still folded, snip 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 small slits down the fold side of the paper. Then begin to add paint to one side of the butterfly, whatever colors and designs you want. Then fold the paper over, smooth it out with your hand, and open it back up, and voila, there's your symmetrical butterfly. For the antennae, you can tape together 2 bendy straws or use 2 chenille sticks. For this butterfly, I decided to use 2 bendy straws. So I taped them together, then I weaved them in and out of the little slits that I put in the butterfly. Here's an example with chenille sticks for antennae. The 3D hearts and craft sticks butterfly is really cute too. All you need are colorful construction paper, 2 craft sticks, 2 googly eyes, scissors, pencil, glue or glue dots, and chenille sticks cut in half. First, pick 3 different color construction paper. Fold each paper in half and draw a small, medium, and large heart shape with the bottom of the heart at the fold. Glue the medium heart on top of the large and the small heart on top of the medium heart. Then glue two craft sticks in the middle and add googly eyes. Glue the half of chenille stick on the back for antennae. Fold up each side of the heart to make it three-dimensional. The coffee filter butterfly is fun and easy to make. You'll need coffee filters, a plate or paper plates, dot painters or markers, chenille sticks, clothespins, and water is optional if you'd like it to bleed out a little more. Place the coffee filter on the plate and begin painting your design. If you want the colors to bleed together, here's when you'd add a little bit of water drops. Once the coffee filters are dry, you want to scrunch the middle of the coffee filter down to make the center of the body and clip with a clothespin. Then cut off a piece of chenille stick to make an antennae. Once you've attached the antennae, you might even want to use some small pom-pom balls to decorate your coffee filter butterfly even more. The 3D butterfly life cycle is the final craft. To do this cute project, you'll need a paper plate, black marker or crayon, green foam or small leaves, tiny pasta shells, beans or pom-poms, twigs, yarn or brown marker, chenille sticks or rotini pasta, tissue paper or large pasta shells, farfalle, pasta or tissue paper, scissors, glue or glue dots. First, divide the paper plate into four equal parts. Then label each part with eggs, caterpillar, chrysalis, butterfly. Label the outer edge of the plate butterfly life cycle and put hours all the way around it. For the eggs, I glued tiny pasta shells on foam leaf shapes. For the caterpillar, I twisted two chenille sticks together and glued them onto a twig from outside. For the chrysalis, I twisted green tissue paper at the ends and then glued that underneath a larger twig from outside. And my butterfly is also tissue paper with some chenille sticks twisted around the middle for antennae. Feel free to use whatever you have at home. Now let's talk about the science of butterflies. Did you know that butterflies are symmetrical? Symmetry is when it is the same on both sides, and butterfly wings are symmetrical. They are the same on both sides of the butterfly. Symmetry is a fundamental part of geometry, nature, and shapes. It creates patterns that help us organize our world conceptually. We see symmetry every day, but we often don't realize it. Legos have such fun, bright shapes and colors that they're the perfect way to explore symmetry. You can provide your child with half of a butterfly shape so that they could complete the other half with matching blocks. When completed, discuss how each side of the butterfly's wings are symmetrical, reminding your child that symmetry is when it is the same on both sides. Another option would be to start with just the butterfly's body. Then put the same color and shape Legos on each side of the body. It might be helpful to see real pictures of butterflies when your child is creating their Lego butterfly. What starts as an egg, then walks on many legs, and then uses wings to fly? A butterfly! Butterflies are insects. Butterflies change a lot in their short lives. There are four stages in a butterfly's life. Stage 1, egg. A mother butterfly lays many eggs on a leaf or branch. Each egg is close to food, caterpillar food, that is. The egg is sticky so that it'll stay on the leaf in all kinds of weather. Stage 2, caterpillar. The tiny caterpillar bites a hole in the egg. It crawls out. The caterpillar is very hungry. The caterpillar usually eats its shell and then it eats the leaf it's on. The caterpillar eats and grows for 12 to 14 days. Our skin grows with us, but a caterpillar's skin does not grow. When the caterpillar gets too big for its skin, the skin splits down the back. The caterpillar crawls right out of its own skin. It has new skin underneath. This is called molting. Caterpillars will molt 4 or 5 times. The caterpillar moves to another leaf. It eats that too. The caterpillar grows and grows. It gets too big for its skin. It sheds its old skin like a snake. After many days, the caterpillar is finished growing. It is much bigger than when it first came out of its eggshell. It's almost as big around as your finger. Stage 3, chrysalis. By now, the caterpillar is ready to rest. it hangs upside down, it sheds its skin one more time, and the new layer is called a chrysalis. The chrysalis is a hard shell. Inside, the caterpillar is changing. It stays in the chrysalis for 10 to 14 days. The chrysalis is also called the pupa. Every day, the chrysalis looks the same. We can't see anything happening, but inside the chrysalis, the caterpillar is changing. This changing process is called metamorphosis. One day, the chrysalis will start to crack open, and you'll see a head, a body, and then wings. It's a butterfly. Stage 4, butterfly. The chrysalis moves, it splits open, and the butterfly wiggles out. Its wings are wet and crumpled. Blood pumps into the butterfly's wings. They get bigger and harden. The wings dry. Now the butterfly is ready to fly. Did you know it takes about 2 hours for the wings to dry? A butterfly doesn't eat plants like a caterpillar. It has no mouth. A butterfly drinks nectar from flowers. It drinks juice from fruit. A tube on its head works like a straw. There are many parts to a butterfly: head, feelers or antennae for touch and smell, the proboscis, the tube to the mouth for sucking up sweet juice called nectar from flowers, the thorax, the abdomen, the 6 legs, the wings, and the scales on the wings, which make up all the colors on the butterfly. Did you know butterflies taste with their feet? A butterfly mom stomps on a plant to taste the leaves. If they're yummy, she lays her eggs on them. She's making sure that her babies will have lots of food to eat once they hatch. Butterflies prefer nectar from certain flowers and bushes. They like thistle, burdock, zinnia, butterfly bush, and mint. The egg of a monarch butterfly is almost always laid on a milkweed plant. The plant will be its food. Maybe you'd like to plant a butterfly garden at your house. Or you can order your own butterfly garden kit and actually experience the entire life cycle of a butterfly. Did you know that butterflies are found all over the world, except in Antarctica and in the driest of deserts? Sometimes butterflies flutter around in crazy patterns to confuse hungry birds. This is called dodging. A butterfly's most important job is to mate and lay eggs. Most butterflies live for a short time, so they must mate and lay eggs quickly. If you'd like to learn more about butterflies, be sure to check out Butterfly Books at the Cape May County Library. See you next time.